Two new converts stab ROCCG pastor to death in Lagos church. Hello, my amazing family. At the end of your life, people don't remember your weight, but what you were like as a person. Let your conscience guide you this Yuletide season. Please don't forget to give us a like or thumbs up if this is a first time. Thank you. A pastor of the Redeemed Christian Church of God in Festac, Tan, Lagos State, Amuwo Odofin local government area, was attacked and killed by suspected hoodlums. Pastor Babatunde Dada, our correspondent Lane, was assassinated inside the ROCCG Chapel of Resurrection on the 13th Road, 6th Avenue, Festac, Tan. The killing, which happened on Thursday, December 2nd, was said to have been perpetrated by two new converts who came to the church for the first time a Sunday before the incident. The two youth were said to have come out during an altar call and surrendered their lives to Jesus. The church accommodated them on its premises after they claimed to be stranded. They had barely spent a week in the church when they reportedly stabbed the cleric to death. A senior pastor in the church, Akin Odejare, declined comments on the incident when contacted by Punch Metro. However, the wife of the pastor, Bose, told our correspondent on the phone that she called her husband on the day of the incident and he promised to come home to rest. She said, "My husband was killed on December 2nd at the church. He was the admin account officer, as well as the parish pastor. I was not with him when he was killed, but I was told that they collected money from him. I heard that those who killed him were new converts." A family member who is also a security expert, Mr. Abolariwa Olatuboso, told our correspondent on Wednesday that the pastor was killed after withdrawing money from a bank. He said the pastor went to a bank to withdraw some money and went to rest on the first floor of the church. Two persons said to be new converts went to meet him upstairs, broke his head and killed him. The matter was reported to the police and one of the suspects who ran to Ilori has been arrested. Olatuboso said the killing might be for racial purposes, adding that the assailants were suspected internet fraudsters, aka Yahoo Boys. The expert said criminals were beginning to attack churches and pastors because they believed there was money in church. He advised religious centers to be security conscious and put in place strategies that could stop criminals from killing, kidnapping, and robbing leaders and worshippers. A friend of the slain pastor, Fred, who is the founder, High Flyers International Lagos, said in a Facebook post that the pastor was stabbed multiple times. He wrote, "Two boys had come to church last Sunday and they responded to the altar call by giving their lives to Christ. After church service, they waited to see the head pastor and told him that they were stranded without any place to stay." Please don't forget to give us a like or thumbs up if this is a first time. Thank you. On compassionate grounds, the pastor allowed them to stay somewhere within the church premises, pending when they would be resettled. Pastor Tunde Dada, who had for almost a decade been the accountant of ROCCG Chapel
of Resurrection Parish was assigned to provide needed welfare for the boys until their matter would be sorted. On the fateful Thursday, Tunde was seated in his office and the boys targeting that they were alone on the church premises with him, entered his office and attacked him with knives and other sharp weapons. He was stabbed multiple times in different places until they had him killed right there on the spot. Our minds are still searching for what the rift between the boys and Tunde was, considering the fact that the Tunde we knew was a very gentle soul. Could they have asked for more welfare than what was approved for them and Tunde declined? What on earth would warrant his brutal killing by those who were recipients of a server of the church benevolence? There are many questions that we have not found answers to. The State Police Public Relations Officer Adekule Ajisebutu said he had yet to be briefed about the case. Please don't forget to give us a like or thumbs up if this is a first time. Thank you.
Like my people, there is too much wickedness in this world as we speak. Like the killings of pastors inside Redeemed Church is becoming too much. What is happening? Forgive me if I'm wrong, but I will say these are untested, unvented new converts. A rush to make converts at all costs and increase membership tally is quite dangerous. Churches are exploited by this weakness. Like, for crying out loud, anything is possible in this country. This will be a wake-up call to other pastors. Never to accommodate strangers who purportedly feign repentance. If anybody comes to church claiming they are stranded, the church should not accommodate them. Yesterday's angels are the today's demons. Don't entertain them. The church must put strict security in place. Security cameras could have spotted these assailants. Don't ever trust new converts until you are sure they really converted with time and consistency.
Make a yanuna my experience recently. I went for midday mass one fateful Thursday. Usually the mass is scanty, so because I needed to charge my phones, I went to the back pew. On reaching there, I saw a young man lying down. Throughout the homily, this dude was lying. So when it was time for offering, I unplugged my phones and took them with me to drop my offering. Guess what? This young man was no longer lying down when I came back. Instead, he was just shouting at me that, "So now because of me, you carry your phone." To the extent he was screaming and saying he was going to kill himself and not me. At this point, everyone was looking at us. So I decided to leave the church even before the close of mass. We all need to be careful and live with wisdom. Please, if you are here for the first time, there is a bell at the right hand or the left hand. Please click on it for more updates. And most importantly, please tell a friend to tell a friend about Thunderways Media. Thanks for staying with us. Bye-bye.